Hello, my friend, and have a nice day to you. And I hope that you are fine and you have been a nice day, because next I am planning to give you really excellent information. And this my information is today that how I can service these my car's brake calipers. And these brake calipers are very critical parts in modern cars. In front and rear areas we have totally 4 pieces of these calipers, and these calipers works so that when we press our car's brake pedal, then this brake fluid goes through hoses and pipes in through that hole. And then in here inside there is this brake piston. And normally when we have these brake issues, almost all or most issues are that this brake caliper is stuck. And there is situation that there is rusty, corrosion, sand, dusty, oil, anything in between that piston and then this brake cylinder tube. And this brake piston is very similar than in engine piston, same idea. And that's we need in between this piston and then this outer cylinder area good lubrication. And next I will show you that how I lubricate my old cars, this bad and little bit stuck this brake caliper. And now we can look that how to lubricate this Toyota Camry cars, these front brake calipers. And even in Toyota cars, even that these brake parts is made in Japan by Aisin Corporation, what is Toyota's manufacturing company, even these parts, they can be filed and go bad when we have drive more than 200,000 miles. And this brake issues, they are most those issues when Toyota cars has those first defects, because these brake parts, there is so much dusty and sand and rain in these areas that this is very bad area to lubricate. And next, my friend, I will show you that how I lubricate these old brake calipers. And now I also recommend you that if you have any issues in USA with your brake calipers in Texas or California or Alaska or New York and also Miami states, that you do same thing in your brake calipers in Ford cars and also in Toyota cars and all car brands like Mercedes-Benz or then Lincoln. And this is like easy service to do annually. I recommend that you do that annually, and this is like almost free of cost, and then you can guarantee that your brakes are working well. And of course, if you like to be really professional, we can always purchase new swap these new brake calipers. And these brake calipers cost about $200 per piece. And when we have 4 of these, this cost $800. Okay, but in that my case, you can use those old and even little bit worn out calipers. Okay, and then my friend, let's go through that how I lubricate this, and please enjoy for that brake caliper adventure. Okay, and then I have really situation that this my cars, that front brake caliper and piston is stuck and bad. And next I show to you that how to lubricant and service this brake caliper. And now this video and this information is suitable for all of these cars and trucks and even motorcycles where is this brake caliper and it is stuck. And first step is that I have to take this my wheel away and save that my and lift this my car up and also secure that this my car don't drop ground. And let's go to do that then, so that I take my wheel away and then we can look that brake caliper, because this is this video's most important part. Okay, and let's continue. Okay, and now bolts are loosened and then I can lift this wheel away in that way. Now when we are looking this brake caliper, now it is easier to move that brake caliper in here, and that's I have to go to steer my, I need key, and I steer my steering wheel a little bit in that way, and even more in this good position. Okay, excellent. And now we can see this brake caliper better, and let's go to look that closer. Okay, and now my target is to open this bolt and that bolt, and then I can take this brake caliper away. And for that job I need now, it is not 12, it is maybe 14 millimeter socket, 14 millimeter. This socket fits in here and also in here, and then I take a little bit longer bar, because these bolts can be tight. And I install my tool, and opening direction should be, yes, it is in that direction, yes. It starts in here. This is starting point and then opening. And then these bolts opens easily, because this car is Toyota. And Toyota's bolts are really easy to open. And then I open this lower part. Also. Okay, good. Now I take this bolt also away. Okay, and now this part is normally easy to take out, but sometimes I have to use in here my flathead screwdriver. And this flathead screwdriver use works so that I install that in here and carefully I bent that, and now this brake caliper opens easily and I can lift that brake caliper away. And there is some of these brake pads, noise insulation plates, they opens, and there is, then this my brake pad looks okay, and then this second one, that one looks also okay. Cool. And now we can inspect and check that everything is okay, but now we go to look at my issue area. Okay, and there is really situation that this my brake caliper is stuck, and that's I need to compress and lubricate that my brake caliper. And this is this video's top idea, that how I can lubricate this my brake caliper. Okay, and there is idea that I have to add in now in that area in this grease in here, and I have to take a little bit this my protective rubber away, and next I go to take my tools. Okay, and now when I am planning to add in here my crease and I am planning to make this my brake cylinder piston more movable, I need some these sharp tools that I can lift this my protective rubber boot carefully away in that way. This is purpose. And then when I have lift that little bit up, then I have to move this brake piston so far away than possible. And now I take this one of my brake pads in here, and next when I like to press that brake caliper out, there is two options. I can open this bolt in here, and then I can compress this brake caliper away using my workbench. And you will see that in my video. And then other option is that sometimes when I go next to cabin area and I start to press this brake pedal, then this piston, it can come up, and then it is easier to lubricate that area. And let's go to inside next to press my brake pedal. Okay, and now we are in inside, and now my purpose is to start press this brake pedal in that way. This one is brake pedal, and when I press that many times in that way, then this my brake caliper comes out. And let's go to look next this my brake caliper movement when I am same time pressing this brake pedal, that what happens there. Okay, and now we are looking this my brake caliper movement, and now I have to be carefully, because I like only lubricate this this is rubber. When I carefully, I have flathead screwdriver, I carefully insert my tool in here, and I like to lubricate this area where is this metallic area, and then this cylinder tubes, this joint. And that's, I move this my protective rubber away, and now when I like to compress this piston out, I install now second brake pad in here, because otherwise there is risk that there is no any brake pads, that this brake piston pop out, totally out, and then I have big job to install this brake piston back, because this is very solid joint, and that's I use my brake pads. And now I go to inside to press my brake pedal, and please look that how this caliper comes out. Okay, now I compress. Yes, moves, look good, how nicely. Okay, and now I think that this is enough. This is enough, and now I think that I check that is this my caliper. Okay, yes. Now I maybe a little bit, I compress that maybe a little bit too much. But let's look that can I, yes, I compress that too much, because now this is moving. And now I have to install this back. Okay, but it is still possible, because this is not too far away, but now I made mistake. Now I have to compress this my piston back, and first I use my tongs. Okay, and now there's my tongs, and now I am pressing this my piston back. Let's look that can I compress that. Seems to be a little bit stuck. Okay, not yet, but now I think that I can use this my workbench. Okay, and now I like to compress this my brake caliper back, and that's I take this my workbench, there's handle, and now I install that it just in here, it goes very nicely. And now I start to rotate this my handle, and let's look at how this caliper goes back. It's a little bit hard. Now I think that there's maybe this I have to maybe open this bleeding bolt next in here, in that one, that I can release this brake fluid pressure. And next I open that bolt. Okay, and now I have 8mm socket, and when I a little bit open this my bolt, then this compression, it's easier look, and now there is coming that brake fluid out, look. And that way, but now this my piston goes back, and now I can also stop this bleeding. I close this bleeding bolt. Good. And now I can compress this my brake caliper back. In that way, but now it is too hard. And that's I take my workbench again. And I install that in here. Good. Then I start to rotate. And now we can see that how nicely this brake piston goes back. And now we can start to lubricate that. Okay, and now when I am planning to show you that how to service and lubricate this brake piston, because there is normally corrosion. Firstly, I need some penetration oil, and this VD40 is good. This is lubricant, and I install that in here, in that way. And then we have also this penetration oil, what works in same way. And this is like idea that when I install this grease in here, that I am planning to make this rusty and corrosion sylin, this piston, to movable, more movable. That I can use even this my tongs. Okay, now it moves better, good. And then when this my piston moves nicely, I carefully move that my rubber boot, and I install this my brake fluid also in here, in all areas in this my brake caliper, because there is this rusty in that way. And I insert this nose inside this rubber boot in that way. Good. And then I like to compress this my piston again, totally in this inner area. And I use my workbench. Look at how nicely this piston goes out. Sorry, in that way. And then now it's in. And now this my lubricant goes in the cylinder tubes area. And then I have to open this my workbench again, because I need to compress this my piston out in a couple of times. And now when I use this my workbench, I can guarantee that this my piston don't go too much out. Okay, and now when this workbench is keeping its like locking position, next I can go to press my this Kappian Aureus brake pedal again. And we can see that how this piston comes out. Okay, now I am pressing again. And piston is coming out. Good. And now it takes also contact. So this is my workbench. And now I can lubricate this area next. Okay, and now I can install in the inside of this rubber boot. Now I open it again. And in that area I have to install this my grease in here. And now I can actually install in there any kind of grease, like this bearing grease, or then if I have this specific brake manufacturers this greases, like in that one there is this grease, this is excellent in this inner area. Now I open that again carefully, and in that area, I need to install this my grease in that way. And then I install, I use my fingers, and purpose is that this pistons, this outer area, there is this grease, because this piston is similar than car engine's piston, and it needs this oil lubrication, because otherwise it is in corrosion and stuck. And this is this my idea. Now I install more. This is my lubrication, and then I can install this my grease in also in inner, like in drive shaft area, that I little bit lift up this my protective boot, and then I install this inner area, this grease in that way. Look. Okay, good. Good, and all of this inner area, and then I can, and now this grease is inside of this my boot, and then I can compress this my workbench again back, and now I can guarantee that this my piston and cylinder, inner cylinder valve, get this important lubrication in that way. Good. Works well. And I have to repeat that lubrication at least 3 times. And now I compress this my piston totally in that way. Good. Now it goes in, and then I open this my workbench in that way. And this is like safety thing, that this my caliper, that the caliper don't go too much out. Okay, good. And then I have to again go to cabin area. Okay, and now I am again doing this lubrication, that I take this rubber boot away, and now I install this my grease in that area. Now we can see that there is this grease, and then I finger that in deeper, and then also in that low part in here. I have to install again this in also in that area. Okay, good. Now there is this grease. Now there is actually quite much. Now I am hoping that I can install that in there. Good. And now I believe that this my brake caliper, that it has been lubricated well, and now I compress in final time this my brake caliper back. Okay, and now I am doing this final compression, that I compress this my brake cylinder back. And good. Okay, now this brake cylinder is in position, and I can see that grease is coming out, and it means that there's enough that. And then I take my workbench away. Good. And then I install this my brake pads back in here. And then I install this my brake pads back, and in that same time I can install in there this copper paste if I like to. But now I think that this my brake pads are fine, and there is first brake pad, and then the second is in here. Good. And now they are position, and then I install, and then I check also these two bolts, that they are movable, because these are also, I have to grease also these parts. And then there is two of those bolts, and I have to install in this area. Also this my grease in their inner, and I a little bit lift this up. I lift this up, and then I install this penetration grease in their inner, in that area, and also this lower bolt also. And then I have to install in same time in their inner this grease also in these bolts. Okay, and I check that these bolts are moving. Okay, good, this is moving well. And that one also. Okay, and now when I have lubricate also these bolts same way, and they are moving, then I can install this my brake caliper back in that way. And then I noticed that one of the sound insulation plate is away that way. Okay, good. Now brake caliper is in position, and then bolts. First bolt, and then second bolt. Okay, good. And then I have to tap that bleeding bolt, and I have to do this final togue for these bolts. And it is 40 newton meters in this bolt. Okay, and I fasten these bolts. Okay, and there is my togue, friends. And I set this force now in 40 newton meters. 40 is good, I think. And there is, and then set button. And now this is set. 40, and there is my 14 millimeter socket, and then I fasten these two bolts, and when this my torque reference says click, then we know that there is enough force in here. Let's listen. Now this is okay, and then slower. Good. Now both poles are fine, and final part is to test that this my brake disc is moving. Good, it is moving, and then I need to only install back in this my this wheel and tire, and now this brake caliper piston lubrication is ready, and I can guarantee that this my piston is not anymore stuck or jam or bad. And this is like very easy way. And then of course, my friend, that if we need to be like a really professional, then we need to purchase new this brake caliper, this packet and this full brake caliper, and then this brake piston moves really easily in years. But this is like this service and like emergency repair if we notice that our piston is stuck. And let's continue. Okay, my friend, and now I have showed to you the idea that how to compress this brake caliper back using this workbench, and I hope that you can use this information in your work. And my friend, be happy and positive, and see you in next video, and thank you for watching this video.